Yo, and welcome back, everybody, to Mayday Son Mixing and Music. I don't know what this channel is anymore, but I noticed there's a lot of people who liked my videos back in the day for my audio mixing tutorials. So today, we are going to try and explain All the Small Things by Blink-182, covered by Minority905. For those of you who don't know, I do the mixing of their covers on their YouTube channel for the past 4 or 5 years now. Has it been that long? Yeah. And I also do mixing remotely from here in Japan for various other people. So if you would like to have your songs mixed and you like the sound of their records, please leave a comment down below. Send me an email to my email down in the description down below, and we can get to work on your next song or cover. Yay! But anyway, this is actually my second time recording this video, so I wanted to make sure it wasn't 30 minutes like the first time and get straight into it. I want to show you the various techniques that I use to make the song sound the way it is and go through each part as fast as I can and best as I can without making this video too long. So why don't we go ahead and get started? This song is All the Small Things by Blink-182, covered by Minority905. So why don't we go ahead and play a little section of this and you can see how it works out. All the small things, true care, truth brings. I'll take one lift, your ride, best trip. Always, I know, you'll be at my show. Watching, waiting, commiserating. The audio is glitching out. My computer is old, allow me. It's from 2011. Anyway, so here we go. What we're going to do now is break down the first part of the mix, which is actually the mix bus. So what we have on the mix bus, the two bus or whatever, the stereo mix, have something that goes out and everything feeds into this. So what we have here, without playing the song so much and getting my computer destroyed, is we have actually the Hollywood Virtual Tube Collection from the Virtual Mix Rack. Just to give it a little saturation, I actually brought down the mix just a little bit. Running through an SSL here as well, and driving that. I can play it a little bit to see what's going on. Actually not driving it too much this time. And then we have, you know, our CS EQ custom series. So we actually added a little bit of low end here. We actually cut out some of the mid range here to give a little bit more of a scooped sound, because that's how Enema was back in the day. And then we also have the 4K cutout, because I don't like to make the song sound so harsh. So, especially with a rock song like this and Mesa Boogies, we got to try and tame those 4K range there. And then we got the Bomber, which is actually part of the Mix Bus preset. I actually like what it does. Added a little bit of intensity. Makes the song more hit, 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 like that. Anyway, we got the FG Red, which is the Focusrite Red. And got the CLA Rock Dry preset. I set the threshold to just touching 1.5. But we're actually really focusing on this drive section here. That's what we want. And that is the bread and butter of that. Then we also run it through the C4. So the C4 is another compressor, multi-band compressor. I put on an optimal mastering thing. And I'm really using it just to control this section here, the mid-range, because I don't want it to sound harsh, right? And I also want to control a little bit of the low end, because it does get a little boomy. So let's listen to what it does. Very subtle. It's actually controlling a lot of the low end. And then once all the guitars come in, it starts to really push down on the high mid range there. And then it goes through a tape machine. Of course, we want to make it sound nice and analog. And also through mastering of the FGX. So let's actually listen to the song, this little section, without... Let's go to the chorus. This is probably the best part to actually do everything. So we'll go through this chorus here, and we're going to see how it sounds without any of these plugins on. Come on, buddy. Actually, not. We're not. Nope, nope. Our computer is too old. Let's go to the verse. Small things, true care, truth brings. I'll take one lift, your ride, best trip. So let's actually listen to it with all of them on again. Turn off sonar works there. All the small things, true care, truth brings. It's very subtle. It's a very subtle thing. And obviously, there's some gain staging going on there. So, you know, you want to, you'll get a little jump in audio here and there. but I get lazy with my gain staging. So let's go from top to bottom from the drums. So we got the room mics, SDD5. Literally untouched. Did not touch them. They are just the way they are. Don't need to touch them. We got the overheads. I like these samples because the overheads also are not just cymbals. They also include the shells, which lets me actually manipulate them a bit more. So we got some tape just to give it some sound. Didn't really push it. It all adds up in the end. Then we got, here we go. So we cut a little bit of the low end here. We cut up more of the low end here because I didn't want to sound too boomy. And then we got, cut out some of the harshness around 0.8. And then we got a little bit of some bite here. I just used an overhead to rocks preset because I already know how presets work and I just tweak it to my own thing. The Neve's actually doing nothing. It just passes through the transformer here. I'm pretty indifferent to this. I can turn this off. Doesn't matter. The most important thing was actually using the overheads, the wakey wakey, to give it more sound and actually putting on 50%. And then adding the revival, which is actually a saturator, which actually gives it more sparkle. So if we actually turn this off, let's see how it sounds. This is a great way to give life to your overheads by adding 50% of a smashed compressor. And that'll do that for you and give you a little bit more wakey-wakey, a little bit more life. Hats, don't touch. Toms, barely touch the toms. They're really, really good in the samples. I'll probably cut out a little bit more of the boxy sound by cutting out somewhere between 300, 400. And then sometimes, it depends if it's a tom-heavy song, I'll use the filter to cut some stuff out. And you added some low-end on there as well. And I'll add a lot of top-end here to make the stick hits actually cut through the mix on a very dense mix. So it really depends on how much you want to cut out and how much you actually want to add in terms of high end. And if you want it to cut through, don't be afraid to put up like plus 12 or something like that. And then I think for our toms, I think we just did a little bit of a slow attack, fast release, just compression to make sure they're a little even, getting a little bit more attack. Snare drum is really cool because we got to get that Travis Blink-182 goodness. So we actually used the sample, which was the Tama brass, to give it that ring initially. So you want to make sure you have good sound there. We actually drive the snare drum. What if I took it off? Kind of just helps you deal with the transients. So it's not so much like pa, like a pa. It's more of like a ka, ka. So it's a lot better that way. So that's pretty much the snare drum. And for this particular song, we wanted to make it really hardcore. So what we did here, we cut out a little bit of the unnecessary low end. Not too much because it's already thin sounding snare to begin with. Cut out some of the low end. You don't really need to with the sample because they're already ready to go. Add a little bit more crack at the 1600 range. Add a little bit more spice at the 7K range. And a little bit more top at the 12K range up here with the Neve. Little tiny increments with the Neve because the Neve is a very, very powerful It's a very, very powerful EQ, so you don't need to crank it as much as you would like an SSL. This part is the bread and butter to how to make it really sound like a K-K-K-K. Right? So, basically, without this, just sounds like your man just tapping you on the shoulder. Now it sounds like he's slapping you on the shoulder. Yeah? So that's how you're going to make a snare drum sound more like, yeah, yeah, baby. Yes, you're going to do that for the snare drum. Now, you're wondering, why didn't you add low end on the EQ, but you're adding it here on the thickness? Because if you actually add EQ and add low end, and there's actually no low end to begin with, you're actually not going to be adding anything and just detrimenting yourself more and adding more frequencies of the bad stuff due to the curves and way they push it up. So with saturation, with the revival tool, adding thickness actually creates harmonics, which actually creates low end artificially. So it's better to actually use saturation instead of EQ to create low end. And then after you created that low end via saturation, you could start adding EQ later. So if you wanted to add more, you could actually like put a little bit more here if you wanted to do that. Oh, sorry, you would put it after like this. But anyway, that's how the snare drum goes. And we got the kick drum here.
pretty cool. It's pretty much standard. I just go for a kick rock thing. Cut out the low end. Not the low end. Cut out the low mid range, like the boxy sound around 300, and cut it to my liking. So if I wanted to make it really sound scoopy, rocky, then you can cut out as much as you want. I got it maxed here. Sometimes you want to get the nice, it's like that nice like Motown thick drum, then you wouldn't cut that there, right? And it really depends also on the kick, the type of drum that's recorded, which is nice in the world of samples today, so you can really pick and choose what you want. So it really depends. It's not all cookie cutter. Yeah, we also cut out a little bit some of the higher end. I learned that from CLA. And then we also add some top end here, top end here, top end here, and then more low end here with the Custom Lift Series, which is a great, great two-knob tool. And I really love it to add that low end when you're just in a rut and you don't know which frequency to push up. You can just use this. So listen to this Custom Lift Series without it. Off. On. Adds so much more. And we're adding a lot of high end too to the mix as it gets dense, but not too much because you just want to make sure it cuts through. So it's very important to mix the kick drum and the drums with everything on. Turn it off. See that low end? It's gone. I mean, the high end, the click is gone. So it's much better to have that. Then we just have a standard slow attack, fast release with the second circuit, which makes it even slower, which gives it even more attack on this 1176 here, which is great tool. And I kind of reduced it a little bit more because I thought it was a little bit too much. So I kind of compressed it more than usual, which would usually go around 3 or 4. I went up to the 4 or 5 here and then cut out some of that mix there to make it a little bit more. That's drums in a nutshell. Put some tape on the drums as a whole, and we also put the FG Red to give it some glue, which I'm actually more chasing the drive there to give it more saturation, and then we actually go for the parallel smash here. So that snare really pops out when you actually parallel smash. Very subtle. Very subtle, and it's a very subtle technique you can use. You want to put it so much that you can hear it, but not so much that you can hear it, if that makes any sense. Very subtle, just enough if you hear it, if you're looking for it. Let's move on to the bass. Bass is, I'm trying to just move along here. I don't want this video to be 30 minutes, you know? Is the bass? Very simple stuff, recorded on a cheap bass guitar. So what we actually have to do first is put it through a nice amp. Sometimes you don't have to. Sometimes you can go straight through the DI. We just threw on a quick little ting ting bass phase 59. Got a good sound. It's good enough. We use Bass Rider. This plugin basically lets you control the bass and make sure all the notes are heard. So very important. If you're going to buy any plugin from Waves, buy it on a $29 sale, buy the Bass Rider. Don't even, that's the only Waves thing I would actually condone. Next, what are we doing here? We got the SSL. We got the console, of course. SSL, we're actually cutting out this frequency here. What is it? Oh, no! There's like 300 or something like that. 300 or something like that. And we're actually cutting out the poo-poo sound. We're cutting out the poo-poo sound from the bass. And we're making it a wide scoop because it depends, because sometimes the bass can sound bad at 200. Sometimes the bass can sound bad at 600. Depends on the notes being played. Depends on the bass itself. Depends on the wood. Depends on everything. So usually I'll go for a nice wide scoop and keep things simple. I like to keep things really simple. And we actually like to cut out the low end here too to help control those resonances that will just burst kind of through. The Bass Rider does help, but just to control that. And then artificially add low end later if I need to. Sometimes you don't need to. Sometimes the bass guitar itself or the bass amp that's being recorded to will provide natural low end. So you don't always need to do that. You can just do it. Let it go. Just leave it alone, yo. Mary Mannequin. 1600 area to kind of bring up the more of the string attack. And then 3000 hertz to kind of bring up more of the bite to it. Then we added the bass guitar. What did I do? The fat and warm, because I wanted to have a nice fat warm sound. Just enough. Get a little bit of saturation in here. Put the output a lot to give it a little bit more saturation naturally. Just keep it more. I probably could have done more compression, but The song was already compressed enough. It didn't really need to do anything. Just wanted to make sure it's heard. It's more of a bass sound. For Mark DeLong, you know, you don't even notice if you put... Yeah, this chords, right? So it's very important, depending on your artist, right? Like, what you want them to hear as a bass player or something. So for something like Mark, when I call him Mark DeLong, Mark Hoppus, what he does is, like, he likes to play a lot of the chords. So it's very important in a Blink song to kind of show that. So you want to show a little bit more attack when it's combined with everything, right? Oh, I don't know if it's going to do it because I've... Probably not. Yeah, it's not going to play it, but you know, it's going to be, you know, you want to make sure everything kind of goes through. I really should just bounce these things out and just play that, eh? That'd probably be better. Okay, so next thing here, we're going to go to the guitars. So the guitar sounds. So the guitar sound. It's almost very raw. So what amps did we use? I know there's a lot of guitar mans that want to hear this. So I think we use channel 2 on a Mesa. You can take a look at that, which goes into a greenbacks. Is it a greenback? Let me see. Nope, it's not a greenback. You can go for greenbacks, but we go through a Marshall cabinet, which is cool. And basically, what we got here is we got some tape to give a little more fatness and saturation to make it sound more real. What if I turn it off? Gets a little cold, eh? Very subtle. Oh, very subtle, huh? That's important, right? When you might want to make guitars sound better, especially if you're using amp sims. Next thing we got here, we actually cut out instead. Sometimes I'll boost the high end around the 7K range, but this song didn't need it because Mesas are very, very trebly anyway, so don't even want to bother with that. Actually cut out some of the high end here. What if I turn this off? Listen. Just control it a little bit and make it a little bit more metal by cutting out the 700 range there. And I actually didn't even touch. I didn't even touch the high pass filter. Sometimes you don't have to, guys. Sometimes you just don't have to. And added some thickness with the distressor here on the right. So it's all subtle movements here that will really add up to it all in the end. Let me get rid of that. Sorry. Okay. And then we got a C4 here, which actually is controlling the rumble when they do like the jink, 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 the palm mutes. You want to control that rumble there and also controlling when the open chords come in. So if you can see it here, it's already getting bad. I probably could have done a high pass filter. I don't know why I didn't at the time, but just controlling a little bit. Just a pinch, but not too much. I remember I was playing with this too much, and then the guitar started sounding too thin. So I feel like with Mesas, there you go. See, with the Mesa, it gets really messy and abrasive if you don't control those high mids. So what we got here? We got quads. We don't even use them. We did in the beginning, but I didn't end up using them. I wonder if my thing's crashing. I got like an amplitude open on all these things. I really should just bounce these out. Next thing we're going to do is the octaves. God damn it. Very simple, guys. Very, very simple. Cutting out the low end. You don't want it to get messy. Give the man some space down there. Add a little fatness of the mid-range. There's like the mid-range knob of your guitar amp to make it more fat. And adding leveling compression to make sure you don't lose any of the losing the notes. You want to make sure it's nice and even. And also cranking up the output to give a little bit more saturation to help it push out a little more. I like to use a lot of saturation if you haven't noticed. Next part of the instruments I want to show you is actually this secret synth that you guys had no idea about. I'm telling you. There's a secret synth in the song that you had no idea. If you listen to it, it's like this. Yeah, son. Hear it? What if I take it out? Oh. You didn't even notice that, did you? Very key. That's what makes it catchy. Put this on. So this synth here, I actually had to construct myself because I'm bad at synthesizers. Using a retro synth here. Take a look at that. Boom, baby. Take a picture. Pause the video. I don't know. And basically just used leveling and compression to make it audible. And it's really, really just a balancing game at that point for that part. Next cool part is the bridge. So this part down here is a nice AVA, bro. So Angels and Airwaves, Tom DeLonge's like, yo, I want to make it sound spacey. So he actually has a part here like this. And hear it. Why? Oh, I must have something soloed. There you go. Just take time to appreciate this bridge section. Piano. Guitar. Delays on it. What a great part, man. Listen one more time. Space sound. We got the drum part here. This part where the rooms come in. Very important for the rooms to have that sound. If I took it out, so it's an intimate sound. But once you have the rooms in, right? So that's a cool part there. And then the synth comes back in to take its place. Listen to that. Beautiful. Plays out at the end. And that's it, yo. Let's go to the vocals. You think I forgot? So, let's see how the vocals are now. So, when John sends me those vocals, I have to tune them sometimes just to clean it up. He's usually very good and you don't need to really tune it, but just got to be perfect, yo. So, we throw on some tuning on there, figure out the key to the song, C major. Then we also go and put vocal line on here because the enema sound is a very, very manufactured sound. So the way Tom gets his vocals to sound so like spacey-ish is by doing perfect double takes. And the way we do that is by using Vocaline here. And if I actually unhide it, you can actually see the old track here, which is the old track. Got some Vocaline on here. And then you bounce that out. And then you make it ting-ting so it gets perfectly in sync. So let's listen to all these vocals sound by itself. Oops, I don't know if it's going to play it. Nope, I should probably chill and go over here instead.
True care, truth brings. I'll take one left, you're right, best trip.
So for my vocal processing, we got a Vox 1 preset here, then I work with it from there. So I cut out a little bit of the high pass filter here, cut out some of that low end we don't need. Actually boost some low end because when we cut out the boxiness at the 300, 200, 400 range, we actually lose some of the fidelity and the vocal starts to sound thin. So we actually want to add a little bit more low end to kind of bring it back, but it's controlled because of the high pass filter controlling that. So you get a nice focused curve when you're boosting instead of boosting the entire thing with this bell curve here. And then we can also increase it by going 6K, giving him a little bit more bite, and then add a little bit of top air to give him some sprinkle there. And adding just a tiny bit more about the 4K with the knee because the knee was a very strong EQ. And then adding some more of that thickness back into his vocal by using the distressor. So let's listen to the vocal.
Always I know you'll be at my show.
And then we add some sprinkling with the CLA vocal, which is an amazing plugin. It's magic. It just works. I feel like cheating, but you know, sometimes you got to do it. So for this one, I actually add a little bit of a stereo effect to give that more spacey quad track sound instead of adding quads itself. You can kind of simulate that and give the vocals more space. Very useful in the chorus, Maybe I'll make a tutorial on that after how to make the choruses pop. Slap, we got the tight, we got the spank, we got the top, and we got the sub. And sometimes I'll use the sub to bring back some of that life. Sometimes I won't. Sometimes the top, I can cut it out. And this is just some extra compression to make the vocal sound very rocky and compressy. Vocals for the double is exactly the same. It's exactly the same thing. Keep it simple. Now, the harmonies is the last thing we're going to do here today. It's pretty easy, to be honest. I use the same kind of setup. I'll just copy and paste it. Same vocal. Make some adjustments if the vocalist is different. If it's the same person, in this case, it's not. It's actually Chris. Oopsies. Computer's old, guys. I know. You'll be... Okay, my computer is old, man. It's not going to play it anymore. So no tuning on there. Didn't have to because you actually don't really hear discrepancies in audio in tuning in the higher registers more than you would at the lower ones. So you didn't need it. And it's not that loud in the song anyway, so it doesn't even matter. Don't have to stress over that. But the important thing is to use this here. The CLA-2A, buddy. LA-2A. Smash these vocals. In a rock song, you want to smash these vocals down so you're not getting dropouts in audio and sound. When you have these things both left and right, they got to be nice, consistent. They're just another instrument, just like the guitars, right? So, smash them.
Always, I know you'll be at my show.
It's more oomph. But even in the song, look, it's not even that much. At my show, if my computer wanted to do it. So, that's basically how the vocals and everything went. We got a bunch of extra tracks here that I ended up using. The na-na-na-nas is the same kind of principle. What did I add? Yeah, I think I put more stereo effect. Yeah, put more stereo effect to give it more of that depth. Very subtle. And it's actually left and right. It's actually left and right. So that's how that works there. And I also like to use a lot of file stacks, folder stacks to make everything nice and efficient. But anyway, guys, I think I'll finish it off there, and I won't play the song. If you want to play the song, click the link down below, and you can watch the video there for the final release product that came out for Matter 95, Blink 182, All the Small Things cover. Anyway, guys, that's all I'm going to do for today. Thank you so much for watching and listening. I hope you learned something. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comment section down below. I am looking forward to be making more of these and getting back into the audio game. And of course, if you want your own songs mixed, drop me an email, drop me a comment, drop me a DM, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And we can see what we can do for you to make your song sound great too. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. Maybe we'll make another tutorial on some smaller techniques moving forward. Who knows? And of course, I'll be releasing music sometimes if I can. I'm working on my comedy channel at this moment, so I've been doing that much anyway. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. This is the third time I'm saying it. Peace out. A-Town. Peace.